Jay Shrek. I'm going to tell you what. We are in probably one of the most beautiful desert settings. And I'm going to turn you around real quick so you can take a look. Look at that beauty right there. Look at this desert. This desert is unreal. Now, where are we at today? Well, we're right now on a place called Cipriano Pass, which is right outside the Road of the Devil, which is actually, we're heading into the old real Road of the Devil that went on down to Yuma. But I'm telling you what, this is one of the most spectacular deserts that I have ever come across in our travels anywhere. Now, this area was kind of treacherous at one time. You know, there's been murders here. There's been countless smugglers here. And this is a split between the Gila Mountains and the Tinajas Altas, which is this group. And then right here would be the Gila Range. Now, here is the split that goes through. So there's not that many trails that you can get through if you're smuggling goods back or forth. Now, we're looking for Winchester rifles today that were hidden in these caves. And we'll get into that story a little later. But look at this spectacular beauty around us. My gosh, what a beautiful day. This is going to be an unreal adventure today. We're looking for Spanish petroglyphs. We're looking for Winchester rifles. We're looking for locations that a guy up here didn't have such a great fate. And we'll get into that story a little later, but look at this. Man, are you ready to go today? I'm telling you what, I am stoked today. I'm ready to go. This is really unreal. Look at this road. This is the famous Cipriano Pass. You take a look at this. We're at Raven's Butte, and I'm going to tell you what. You talk about spectacular. Now, what we did was we went around. If you look over here on the other side of the truck, we've taken this road here back as far as we could get it. Now, this is considered to be the land of 1,000 caves. So within that cave is hopefully a Winchester rifles, which is hopefully Spanish petroglyphs, and hopefully is native artifacts. Now, we're told that in these areas is all that stuff. So let's talk about hidden treasure. So somewhere up in these mountains, in one of the 1,000 caves, is supposedly a wagon full of Winchester rifles. Now, the amazing thing about the story is that there were some individuals that were creative, and what they were going to do was they were going to take wagons full of rifles to the revolutionaries in Mexico. And one of the wagons broke down. So they couldn't fix it. So what they did was they took the rifles and they hid them in one of these caves in this mountain range up here somewhere, right? Now the story goes, they took the additional wagon trains to Mexico, but they were foiled by the federales. So basically what happened was they captured them, and so no one ever came back to get the additional rifles. So somewhere up here is a priceless cargo of Winchester rifles. And on top of that, there are ancient artifacts up here, and there is also Spanish artifacts as well. So, man, the treasures are here. The problem we have is finding this vast land and getting up here and figuring out which one of the thousands of caves that are up here. Wow. Can you imagine how incredible is this whole area? And it could be in any one of these canyons. What we've counted is maybe two or three different canyons. So it's just a matter of trying to find the one that maybe of the 1,000. And you know, many people have tried, but wow. You know, you want to talk about being in the middle of nowhere. We are in the middle of nowhere. Now, Mexico is right over that range right there. I'm going to say 6, 7, 8 miles. So we're on the border. And let's see if we can't find some of this lost treasure that's down here. Wouldn't that be incredible to see the Spanish? Wouldn't it be incredible to see some of the ruins? Wouldn't it be incredible to find a cargo of missing Winchesters? Wow, wouldn't that be incredible? We're gonna walk over to that structure over there just to take a look and see what's over there. You know, you gotta take a look at this stuff, you know? You have to see, because you never know what's around the next corner. Now, one thing we gotta do is we gotta find one of the, I'm not gonna say we're gonna find all of them, but we have to find at least one of these treasures that we're looking for. And I would love to find the rifles, but you know what? If I can find the Spanish petroglyphs, then this trip was more than worth it. And that is a piece of lead. Now, I don't know what that is. That's pretty incredible. I'm not even sure. Now, it looked like there were screws on the end. But what would be out here that would look like that? Well, maybe we found our first treasure of the day. You know, how in the hell could that be out here in the middle of nowhere? And God only knows what this is. I'll have to take a look at it. Have John take a look at it and see if he can figure out what it is. Definitely incredible. And the smells out here today with the flowers are absolutely unreal. So there's a lot going on today. So, you know, we've just come around this corner. I'm looking for some areas that I think maybe possibly are some good cave areas. Now, I'm going to tell you, this rock right here, extremely difficult to hike on. Now, I'm not going to head up into any of these holes unless I feel pretty confident what I got, because we're going to do a lot of hiking today. We went basically to the farthest west point, and going to take a look around. If there's anything promising, then I would definitely go up there. So that's not even an issue, but I don't want to go up there unless I see something and I go, wow, that looks like something that would be interesting. Don't turn off now. We're getting to get close. Man, we ain't stopping. You know how what we do. But I'll be honest with you, I've got not a clue on where this is at, where this tank is also. So if I find the tank, I'm most likely going to find what I'm looking for. Now you know why there could be cases of rifles out here and you'd never find them. When you get out here, you realize that, you know, a lot of times you're like, well, enough people have been out here and seen this. Well, no, you could have rifles anywhere out here and you would never see them. So one thing I want everybody to look at is, so where am I looking, right? Well, I'm looking in these creek beds with these trees. So that's telling me that these trees are getting water. So if you're getting water, then I'm in a location that potentially there could have been ancient people, could have been Spaniards, could have even been cavalry and some other people coming in the Old West as well. Because if there's trees that size, then this is a water source of some type. I like this area here. I like the fact that I got a water source. We got a place that we should have some type of tinajas. And then we've got some shelter. Doesn't mean it's there, but we're going to take a look. It'd also be off the ground. I like that. So we're going to climb up that rail and across there and see if there's anything up there. gonna be pretty tough, actually. I'm gonna take care of where we put our hands today, too. I'll slip over there. We got some type of animal in there. Not the animal we're looking for, though. That was interesting. Very interesting. Getting down that. No such luck, though. No luck. So, we'll work our way on back down here. But that's what we do. You keep going. You keep looking. You know, when you're searching this stuff, we're gonna run that wall over there. But as we walked by here, we saw this and it was like, well, we gotta take a look at it. So we're gonna take a look at it. I don't think it's anything. What's up there? Yeah, that actually is a nice shelter. There's nothing in it. But I tell you what, that is a sweet shelter right there. It looks like there's a little bit of black on the walls. Make sure there isn't anything in here. Okay, this is kind of what we're looking for. An area that'd be similar like this. So the nice thing is we found something that's similar to what we're looking for. Even though that wasn't it, I think we'll try over in that area over here. Okay, we're gonna take a walk down this wash. We're gonna look for this tank that's down here, because once we find a tank, now, what's got me going is, man, there's a lot of green down in here. So that means that there is water that comes through here. And there is trees on this backside over here. So we're gonna take a walk through here, this wash, see if there's anything up on these ledges, and if it's not here, then we're going to try this backside over here. And that looks like that could be a Tinahas up there, actually. Boy, it's hard to tell. You know, this is the frustration of doing this, is that, you know, you keep looking, and it never is easy. Well, it hadn't been yet. But, like I said, at least the scenery is a little more interesting going up through here. There's more cans up here. You know, I got a breeze coming through here, which kind of makes me think, okay, as weird as this sounds, it's telling me to keep going up this draw, okay? That is interesting. I have to go to the top now because that's too crazy. So somebody's been spending time up here doing something. Now, why would you picnic up here? Why would you choose here? Whew. Why would all that trash be there? And again, some of that's pretty old. Just funny how, why does somebody eat their lunch there? I don't see any location where you can see anything. Looks like a cave at all, anywhere. Well, you know, I was kind of hopeful that we would look. So we walked this ridge line right here, right? And then I saw that tree up there about halfway, and then that's where I found the trash. Really bizarre though, it's got old trash and new trash. Some of the trash is ancient, and then some of the trash is new. So what were people doing up there? Now I went to the top and we looked over, right? I didn't see anything that would lead me to that. So what's my plan? So when you're doing this, what are you looking at? Okay, so if there were Spanish in here and there were natives in here, they were going to a location where there was water. So that's kind of why I thought about up here was with the trees, that means that they are getting water flow through here. So it's definitely not gonna be on the Chocolate Mountain right here, right? It's not gonna be on Raven Butte. It's gonna be on this wall somewhere here. And so what we need to do is kind of look at it. Oh, dang it. Oh, see, there you go. I'm talking to you guys and I just had a chola in the side of my leg, side of my foot, and that hurt. So when you're jacking around and through my leg, wow, that was no fun. That's what happens when I was concentrating on the hill and not concentrating on what the hell I was doing. Don't do that. That's so stupid. So what I'm looking at is right here, what looks like Tinajas altus. So what structure looks like that? Because I kind of figure out how it makes those natural rock formations. So, and one thing we found was we found caves in that area as well. So we're going to work this ridgeline now. So this looks pretty promising through here right now. It does. I mean, this looks like something that it looks like we're going to get into something right here.
You
want
to
say it is, but
stop before we keep going.
No, let's keep going and we'll work our way back out. How's that? I kind of like that idea.
Maybe. There are Indians here in the
park. Because I smell.
Look at elephant tree up there.
Oh, yeah, elephant tree. Doesn't that up there look kind of... Yeah, but doesn't that kind of at least look more like what we're kind of looking for? Yeah, we're at the end of the road now.
Yeah.
Okay. So here we are. We're looking for the Raven tank, and this looks like kind of the structure we'd be looking for right here. So I jumped out of the truck, we took a ride down that road, so one way or another we're only going to be somewhere right in this area. You know, I don't see the caves that I saw, you know, on the map, some of the pictures, but you know, we've not seen this cave. So the cave would be by the tank. Let's see. At least there's an indention there, which is a little promising to some degree. See if we can't skirt this tree right here, stay up on the high bank. But is there a water source? That'd be the second thing. Like I said, I'm following somebody's boots right here. Well, there's a good sign up there. See the white rock? Like they've had a lot of water running. That's definitely a good sign right there. It's like another world up here. Look at this. You know, regardless of what we find or what we don't find, this has been an unbelievable journey today. Well, we're working our way up this canyon right here. And I wanted to make sure I turned this back on so you guys could see what I'm dealing with right now, which, just kind of take this is some of the craziest landscape now that I've gotten these huge boulders. Wow, look at the big rocks up here, man. I still do not see anything of a cave, and I don't see anything that looks like a Tinajas. Well, we're out here by ourselves today, man. Look at this jungle. Well, let's go down here. I don't see any signs of anything. at all. A lot of weeds, a lot of deep weeds. Shoot around through there, come back around. Get underneath those rocks because that's pretty spectacular, even if that's not a cave. Looks like the ditch I'm getting ready to go through. Look at this crazy thing. Okay, so I wouldn't say they're caves, but I would say that there's areas underneath these rocks. I think I took the wrong turn. I don't know how I'm gonna get through here. This is pretty thick. Shows that there has been a lot of water. So let's work our way over there. I think we might have to go back the other way, dang it. Into the creek right there. And well, hopefully that gives me an easy charted path through here. This is some of the craziest stuff I have been through, hands down. Some of it's gotta be bad. Just haven't gotten into that yet. Looks like either way I go, it's kind of crazy. So let's just work our way through whatever we think is the easier path. Look at this crazy place. Wow. Okay, we found petroglyphs. Okay, so here we are. We have found mortars right here. Oh my God, I don't know what the hell's in there. I want to make sure that thing's clear. There we are. Oh my God. Wow. Here we go. Here we go back again. It's crazy. Wow, we found them after all this. You know, I'm gonna get some pictures so I can have Hari do some de-stretch on it. As soon as I'm sure there's nothing in there, I'm gonna crawl back in that. I'm gonna get a hold of John, see if he wants to come this way. Wow, look at this. Oh my God, there it is. There it is. Holy shit. Look at that. Oh my God. There is the cross. 17, like 31, right there. There is the Spanish cross. You have got to be kidding me. Holy smoke. Oh my gosh. Man. How cool is this? I tell you what, again, you can't give up. You can't stop. You got to keep going. You can't ever stop. Here it is. We found the infamous 17. Looks like 31 right here. There's the cross. There's the marker there. Oh my gosh. Wow. And there they were. So that shows that they were here. You know, the ancients were here because there's the mortars underneath here. So now we got to check that cave out, and I'm going to dig in there as soon as I catch myself and everything I've got on this, make sure I've got everything. Oh, man. I cannot believe I found this. I cannot believe. Wow! Damn it. I'm so excited. I'm so stoked. It's crazy. It's crazy. I'll tell you what. Is this incredible or what? I've got pictures of all these, but they're all on the ceiling. Now, once John gets in here, I'm going to go back into that cave. And I got a weird feeling once I go back in that cave, I'm going to find some stuff. So I'm going to go back in here, but I'm not going back in until I flush it out and I make sure it's clear. I'm going to be armed, but here's mortars here, right? So you see mortise through here. Now, here's what's extremely funny. So that article from 1940 said that there was a piston and a ring from a Model A. And as crazy as that sounds, that looks like a ring. So how crazy is this we found this? I'm baffled by it. I'm baffled by this. I'm so stoked. This, you know, every time we say that there's some type of bigger thing. Now, I have taken pictures of all this, and we're going to use a process we call de-stretching, which it looks psychedelic. Looks like there's a black light on it, but it will pull out stuff that we can't see with the naked eye. But you can definitely see this right here, 1731, and then whatever that says right there. That, and there's a cross right here. Look how cool that is. This is one of the most incredible spots that I have found, that I've came across. And man, I am as pumped up as you possibly can be to find this. And like I said, I can't wait to go in that cave, and I can't wait to take you, but I am gonna wait. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna work my way through here, see if I can find anything else now that I found this here. And so we're gonna work our way up through some of this area right here, definitely try not to fall, and see if there's, because again, you know, if you find one, then you're gonna find there's more signs of this kind of stuff. I tell you, there it is down there, right down there. So we're gonna check all this. We're gonna make sure that we have walked all this stuff. We're gonna be extremely careful. But man, tell me you can't have Indiana Jones moments in Arizona still. You know, I think I'm the first to get the picture of this, with the exception of the guy that did it in 1940. And that, to me, that's pretty unbelievable. And the fact that he said there was a piston and there was a ring from a Model A. And guess what? That looked like the ring down there, which, man, that is unbelievable. So we're going to journey on up here a little bit. And so there you are. There's the Tina Haas down there. Now it's dry, but there's where it was. So this is the whole reason they would come to this area. It's right down there in that hole. Man, I know you guys are feeling this one, man. I'm telling you. The adventures just keep getting bigger, and they just keep getting better. And I am so pumped up right now. Look at this crazy rock. Look what we're doing. Look at this craziness. This is crazy. Man, I can't even get over all this. Area down here. Maybe I can come in the back way. Because I'm just wondering if there's anything down there. I mean, these ancients were here because, again, you know what I did? I tracked the water, right? That was the whole purpose of this kind of journey, was tracking the water, right? Okay, I was up here, right? And I'm working way down here. This is kind of a little hairy, not super hairy, but you know, I'm also climbing with one hand. Now I'm gonna work my way through here, see if I can't get over here. And I don't know what's down there once I get down there. But, oh Jesus Christ, that big ass rock just moved. Holy smokes, wow. I just moved that rock. Now, why I'm interested in down here is there's a kitchen down here. I don't know if I can even get in there, but damn it. Maybe I can get around there. You guys are seeing what I'm seeing. As soon as I'm seeing it, okay, I don't know if I can get through there or not. Wow. You see what I'm seeing? Wow. I'm gonna have to put my glasses away for this. And then I might have to put you in the pocket to get down here to this next level.
So I'm telling you what, we're exploring now, boys. I'm telling you what, we ain't playing anymore. Now, I'm going to a level that I don't think people have been at. Now, I don't, you guys are digging along with me. That was a dumb move right there, even though I got away with it. Okay. And this might even go back another way. So, got nothing here, but look, here we are. Look at this. Wow. Look at this place. There's our water right there. And it looks like I don't have to climb back up there. Tell you what, that was an interesting climb right there. Okay, I ain't just lying. So we came through there. I guess we can look down there while we're here to see if there's anything down there while we're here. I don't think there will be, but hell, we're here. So let's get in here and make our way. Is there anything up in here? Let me see. I don't see anything. Okay, we're doing the deal today. Who would ever dream this is here? I would have not. Heavy breathing today. Heavy breathing today. Okay, my feet are wet. And that's not a good move. Now, it's funny, I don't see any more art. Look at this place. Tell me this isn't a gold mine. Tell me that. This isn't a gold mine. Look at that rock there. Look at this. Wow. There's that. What's this crazy thing stinging out of there? Just gotta make sure we don't miss anything, because they could have done these ceilings just as well over here. I'm not gonna get on that thing. That thing will take you for a ride. You would be down in there. Well, I'm telling you what, if this doesn't get your adventure heart going, then you know what? I don't know what to tell you. How crazy was this so far? And we're not done. We're still going through the cave. And I'm not done thinking that there's more stuff to this. Look at that big rock down there where they're doing all that work. Just kind of go over this hill and see. And you know, there's no tracks of anybody through this wash at all. I don't see anybody. So, you know, how crazy is this? And then this one, look at that. I still think there's stuff over there. So I'm gonna walk through that creek and go up. Okay, we're going in right now. Let's take a look. We're going in this cave. If I can get in, okay, there's my gun. Dallas, let's get in here. Okay, so let's take a look and see what we got. We're gonna get in here. See if there's Winchesters in here. Make sure there's no snakes. Here. You take that. No Mojaves. Okay. Okay, is everybody seeing here? Let's get back in there. Okay, we're looking up the hill. I don't see anything in here, and there's nothing on the ceiling. Damn it. I was hoping to find a case of Winchesters. Damn it. Well, I can see to the end. Damn it. No Winchesters. Well, we tried. I would give it hell, but we found it, what we were looking for today. Isn't that incredible? John got to see it before he died. Maria sent it to Chile. Well, what an incredible day today. I'm telling you what. That is unreal. To find that in the valley, to realize that Spanish explorers were in this very spot, that ancients were here, the natives were here. How incredible is this spot? And I tell you what, it's one of my favorites. I think it is my favorite. How incredible to see car parts up here. Adventure's not dead, man. And you can look up on the internet and you can see it. And I'm telling you what, it's still alive. And how much fun is this that you can still experience this? And wow, it's the real deal. It is the real deal today. I appreciate you guys coming along. It's been an awesome experience. If you can, donate to Patreon. We appreciate the support of the channel. Like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. It shows that you care. Watch us live every Wednesday, 6 o'clock Mountain Standard Time. I think we'll get in the truck. I think we'll get something cold to drink. I think we'll get down the Devil's Highway, and we'll head back to Phoenix. Jay Shrek, take care. Thanks for coming along with us.